Hello, greetings from Brussels, and I'm Ekaterina Clifford from All Digital. As you know, now we are running an All Digital Week campaign. This is our annual digital inclusion campaign, and of course, this year it is running in unprecedented circumstances when all the schools are locked down and we're all working from home. So we're meeting with some of our national partners in different countries, and now I have Ivan Musanovic from Croatia, Center of Technical Culture Rijeka, our national partner. Hello, Ivan. How are you doing?
Hello, Katerina. Hello, everyone. Well, it's okay. You know, we're adapting to the situation, working from home, so trying our best.
So, did you have to adjust your work to adapt to the crisis and pandemic?
The good thing is that at the beginning of this year, when it wasn't like the situation so serious, we already did some steps to make to digitalize our work. You know, we can all connect to our database, to our hard drives in the company premises. We all have like a lot of online tools for collaboration. So I would say that we are like good prepared for working from home. The biggest issue is that most of our work is done directly with people, so education-wise and so. So that is like the biggest problem. That is like the challenge that we now have to face.
Yes, we all know that you can do a lot of advanced training online, but it's basically impossible to do basic digital literacy and first clicks with people needs to be done with supervision.
Yes, of course. Yes.
So what is the priority now for your organization? What support is needed most of all as you feel it in the community?
The people, they need like basic skills, as you said. So we're trying to share some advice with them. We're producing short videos or short like instructions on how to improve their productivity from home, how to use some online tools. And of course, regarding the whole situation, it is very important what we're doing in this other project, Digital Facts Rate. It's important to know about this information, because a lot of it is going around lately, and it is very important for people, you know, who maybe are not working from home, but just listening to information about the whole situations, to know what to believe and what not to believe.
Yes. Are you planning any webinars in the nearest future? And what are your current daily routines in terms of training? Have you changed anything? Did you have to scale? I guess you had to cancel all the face-to-face meetings, but did you have any online training planned instead of that?
We currently have, as part of All Digital Week, we created competitions, online competitions for our participants, so they can participate in that. And we are also trying to transfer most of our face-to-face workshops to online courses, where, you know, using different tools so that we can still hold the education just, you know, through online means. And now we're preparing all of that. I hope that soon we will make like a bigger portion of our education will be online.
And the trainers are prepared for that. You already have experience with online learning.
Yes, yes, yes. During the many of other projects, we have we had both like mixed courses, your blended courses, where part of them were held online and part face-to-face. So now it's just switched to only one.
Yes. And do you have any extra requests from schools to help you set up distance learning? Or they're already, in a way, prepared to do it themselves?
We are here to help them, but they're mostly in Croatia. It's, I would say, pretty good. Because the national television is broadcasting the schools, the program from the schools, and teachers do know how to do some portion Yeah, but we are always here to help them, and we are currently thinking of ways how to enable them maybe like to host some of their courses, not only schools but other organizations, how to help them. And now we're thinking about the best ways to enable them to do so.
Yeah, that's nice to hear that teachers are not totally shocked about the current situation and how to change their work, because of course it's a big pressure on them as well. How do you manage to motivate your colleagues or your staff or your partners to continue working in this new environment?
Well, we all believe that, you know, during these times, the world, of course, cannot stop, just simply stop. That'll be ridiculous. And I think that the need for digital tools and for digital training, people can, you know, unfortunately, on situations like this, they can see how important it is. So, you know, we're trying to send a message across that, you know, to our partners and to our colleagues that what we are doing is really important, you know, for everything to continue, to be able to continue normally. So, yes, we are trying, you know, to do our share to help things out in these times.
Yes, and I think all of our partners are doing similar things and trying to send these messages. And I should say that All Digital Week campaign cannot come in a more timely time, right?
Yes, I agree.
This is perfect in a way. So is there anything that you have already adopted in your work during this lockdown that you will carry on because it proved out to be efficient or useful?
Well, as I said before, we created this system. These like procedures to work online, because it helps us especially in these times, but you know, also many of us have to travel, you know, on project meetings, you know, all around Europe, and we have obligations on, you know, where we're not in our company premises. So, you know, it is very good to know that you can always access your files, to collaborate with your colleagues, you know. So it's good that we establish like procedures so we can, you know, work all the time, 24/7 from wherever.
We should. We need to have time to have some for ourselves to recharge. And we are not promoting any of the brands or any of the products, but which tools are you using in your work? What are the things that are commonly used?
We are mostly using like Google tools, G Suite. Of course, there is Basecamp, which is proven to be very useful for the organization of work. And of course, different tools for communication, you know, from Viber to Skype to Zoom to WebEx, you know, all the different tools for communication.
Yeah. Yes. So any lessons learned so far?
I'm usually in the Scout, so we have like a motto, and the motto of Scouts is be prepared. So I guess that that is my message to everyone. You know, you should always be prepared because you never know what's going to happen.
Yeah, that's a good way to do it. It actually reminds me of the Soviet pioneers. You know, always be ready, always be prepared for anything, then you can adjust. So yeah. What is the first thing you will do when the crisis is over?
Oof, I don't know. I guess I'm going to go outside and just hugging random people.
Okay, thank you very much, Ivan. Good luck with All Digital Week campaign, and let's stay strong, and let's hope that everything will finish. With. Yeah. And most importantly, stay healthy.
Yeah. And to you too. And everyone stay safe, stay inside until this passes. And good luck to everyone.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.